Hello students, today we'll start with module 2 in digital signal processing, and the today's topic which I am going to discuss with you is a linear filtering using DFT or DFT for linear filtering. And in this topic we are going to study how linear filtering can be done using the discrete Fourier transform. Basically, this linear filtering refers to the linear convolution, and we have studied there are many mathematical methods to compute the linear convolution of the time domain sequences. So how this linear filtering can be done using the DFT? As I said, linear filtering is nothing but a linear convolution, and we know that for any LTI system, if the input is x of n, the output predicted, which is y of n, is always convolution of the input x of n and h of n, where h of n is the impulse response of LTI system. And if I take the discrete time Fourier transform DTFT on both the sides, what we'll get is y of omega is equal to x of omega into h of omega. And if you see all three functions, y of omega, x of omega and h of omega, all these functions are continuous variables, having continuous variables. This w is continuous variable. And these continuous variable cannot be processed. This multiplication between the continuous functions cannot be processed by a digital computer. The digital computer process only the digital data. So then what is the solution for this one? The solution is we have to find the linear convolution using DFT. We have to make use of DFT for linear filtering or linear convolution. So how to do that, right? So let's say there are two signals, x of n is one sequence, say the length of this one is L. What is the length of the signal? L. Another sequence I have is h of n, which is having length m. So here x of n is there, whose length is L. Next, I have to find n point DFT of this x of n. I have to find what? N point DFT of x of n. And this n should be always greater than or equal to L plus m minus 1. Please remember, the number of points for which the DFT is computed should be greater than or equal to L plus m minus 1, right? So this condition needs to be satisfied. Otherwise, what happens? There may be a overlapping of samples or aliasing of samples, right? So here L is there. In order to make the length of this x of n a capital N, I have to add how many number of zeros? Already I have L number of samples. To make n number of samples, n point DFT, I have to add m minus 1 number of zeros. So after adding or appending m minus 1 number of zeros, we will get n point n samples, that is equal to L plus m minus 1. So that now becomes x of n is length capital N, right? Then you find n point DFT of x of n. What you will get? You will get x of k, and the length of this x of k is n. Similarly, the second sequence is h of n, whose length is let's say capital M, right? Again, I have to find n point DFT, and this n should be greater than or equal to L plus M minus 1. So already I have m number of samples in H of N. So to make n number of samples, I have to add L minus, I have to add L minus 1 number of samples, so that you get L plus M minus 1, that is equal to L. So how many number of zeros I have to add now here? L minus 1 number of zeros. Is it clear? Okay. So now here you will get H of N of length N. So that is equal to N is equal to L plus M minus 1. Next, similarly, you perform N point DFT. N point DFT operation. What you will get after performing N point DFT operation over H of N? You will get what? H of K. Next, you multiply these two sequences using multiplier. So here I will multiply these two sequences. So what you will get? I will get X of K into H of K, that is equal to what? Y of K. What I want is Y of N, which is nothing but linear convolution of X of N and H of N, right? So we have here, at this point we have Y of K. How to get Y of N using Y of K? So again, I need to perform N point, which operation, DFT or IDFT? I have to perform N point IDFT. So at the output of N point IDFT, what you will get? Y of N, and this Y of N is nothing but what? Linear convolution of X of N and H of N, right? So you can reduce the computation time, and it is more efficient to perform the linear convolution compared to the mathematical methods, right? And also, this method is easily performed. This multiplication operation in frequency domain is easily performed in digital computer or a digital signal processor. So this method is known as the DFT for linear filtering, right? So briefly I will explain once again. So linear filtering is nothing but a linear convolution. Since there are many mathematical methods to compute linear convolution, takes more time for computation, right? And also if you take the DTFT over linear convolution, you will get Y of omega is equal to X of omega into H of omega. Since they are the function of continuous variables, so this multiplication operation cannot be processed using digital computer, and for that we go for the discrete Fourier transform DFT, right, in order to compute linear convolution. So in linear convolution using DFT, what we do is, the procedure is very simple. So let us choose two sequences, X of N having length L and another sequence H of N with length M. So I have to compute their N point DFT, but if you see the length of this, one is having L and another is having M. So to compute N point DFT, I have to make the length of the both the sequence should be capital N, and this N should be greater than or equal to L plus M minus 1 to avoid any overlapping or aliasing effect. So in X of N already we have L. To make N, I have to add M minus 1 0, so that we will get L plus M minus 1 is equal to N. And here also you have to add L minus 1 zeros here to the M. So once you get capital N number of samples in both X of N and H of N, you have to perform N point DFT for X of N as well as H of N, so that you will get X of K and H of K. Then you multiply these two sequences, you will get Y of K. Now we want the output of the LTI system should be Y of N is equal to X of N convolution H of N. Using Y of K, how to get Y of N? Again, we have to perform the endpoint IDFT so that you will get y of n, which is nothing but x of n convolution h of n. Understood?